Overall, your report, does it point to a recovery in African economies?
It's definitely a recovery, and we see Africa as the shining continent in the world. We can't say it was shielded from the global economic crisis, but it definitely did better than other developed economies, purely because of the macroeconomic policies that these countries did initiate before the crisis came in. For instance, loose monetary policy, spending more during the crisis, and instances like those. So for those aspects, the global economy definitely did worse than what Africa did.
Now, on this shining continent, the shining stars that you picked out, Angola and Nigeria, what kind of growth rates do you think we're looking at from these economies in the next few years?
Well, it's definitely going to be an increased growth rate, but I won't say an extensive growth rate. From about 2009, we saw a great dip in these two economies due to the decline in the oil prices, but of course an increase to about 7.2% this year for Angola. Nigeria, we think, will also be around 7%. And then a small increase to next year. I think the economies are just stabilizing for now. And if the oil price stays as is, then we'll see the GDP definitely expanding. Mm.
Celeste, if I may come in, if you were to categorize these countries that we have in terms of where their growth is coming from, when I look at the numbers, I tend to see the commodity producers particularly faring better than countries without big commodity exports. Would that be an accurate picture of what's going on the ground and perhaps what could drive growth going forward?
Definitely, it would be a good assumption. I mean, Africa is known for its commodities and especially the countries like Angola, Nigeria, South Africa, whose economies are based on commodities. You can see that growth is better there. However, these economies are highly dependent on the commodities, so that's also a danger for these economies. If another crisis hits those countries, then the commodity prices will dip, which will affect the GDP.
I was going to say another crisis hit us, because as I was coming into the studio, we saw a huge sell-off of commodities, your gold, your platinum, your oil, all under pressure. So
yes. There
appears to be a danger here that the double dip that people talked about may actually be realized, given what we're seeing around Greece right at the moment.
From the RMB perspective, we do not see a double dip coming, but we're not ignoring the risks to it. I mean, if you look with the unprecedented policy stimulus that came into the global economy, and with the support of labor markets conditions that's improving now, and also with public or rather private demand also improving, we don't see the global economy doing a double dip again, but the risks are there.
Now, we had the head of the IMF mission in here in South Africa in the studio yesterday. Now, he was saying the key to this whole recovery is fiscal policies from governments in Africa to go for medium to long-term objectives for the economy. How likely do you see this happening from the countries that you've studied?
Well, I think the fiscal policy is the number one reason that actually saved these economies from having a massive dip in the GDP. Only reason being is that these economies were lucky enough to have good growth rates in the 2000s. They were able to accumulate foreign exchange reserves, and this was able for them to tap into that and be able to keep fiscal budgets the way they are, or in some instances even countries increasing their fiscal budget or their government spending. I think these countries must be wary of keeping this spending in case there's a fiscal damage happening in the country. So it's just a matter of keeping the spend, not reining in spending in some countries, but also just keeping on continuing with the same fiscal stance that they have.
Mm. Talking about fiscal policies, I see here Kenya has just released their statement on their monetary policy after their monetary policy meeting, and they're keeping that rate steady at 6.75%, so no change there expected?
We're actually not expecting much change in the monetary policy of Kenya, purely because we see inflation going up again. We do see that the economy is experiencing some growth this year, but I think the major issue will be inflation, food inflation, fuel inflation, that I think that's why the economy or the government decided not to change or cut the rates.
Sure. I suppose when you're looking at the numbers that you have here, you're forecasting for Kenya, for instance, for 2010, 8.2% GDP growth, and into 2011, 7.5%, slight moderation there. You don't think that the economy needs further stimulus, particularly given the low levels that we saw coming as a result of the violence that we saw in January 2008?
Yes, and also because I think the central bank realized if they do cut rates, what they have done last year, I think about 500 basis points from last year, they've realized that it's also not extending credit to the economy. I think that was their main reason why they were increasing or cutting the rates.